Story time. So as I let you guys know in the last video, I am a sexual assault therapist, and today I thought I would share with you the story of Denimday. So there was a case in Italy in the 90s where an 18-year-old was picked up by her driving instructor, and she was later assaulted by him on that same drive. He was eventually convicted of all charges, but later he appealed and it got overturned. And their reasoning was, well, there's no way that he could have taken off her jeans by himself because they were so tight, therefore implying consent, which was obviously not given. So every year on April 29th, we wear denim basically as a big middle finger to rape culture and misogyny. So if you would like to join in, wear denim on April 29th.
Tips for if you find yourself stuck in a psychward. If you know me in real life, please block me. Anyways, I have makeup on. Yes, that's because they take everything away from me that's gloss. So the only thing I could keep was foundation and lipstick. This is lipstick. And I just improvised. Shoelaces. You're not allowed shoelaces. So bring those Velcro shoes or those little slip-on boots. No deodorant cans. So bring like those roll-on ones. Phone hours here are restricted for like 2 hours a day, and then you charge them there. You know, like your phone charges because, you know, no chargers, no shoelaces, no earphones, no cords. If you have a cord, see you fucking later. Most places don't allow you to have jewelry, but here, because I got moved out of the ICU, I could put my jewelry back in, but they take them out there, but like, we moved up. And yeah, if you just want to get out of here quicker, don't fuck anything up and just pretend like you're getting heaps better and just say, I'm cured, and they'll let you go.
Hold on, I still want you. Come back, I still need you.
Guys, I have a message for you today. Sometimes a no means just not right now. Sometimes a door is closed to your dream life because a bigger door is being built for a life that's even bigger and better than you could have ever dreamt of. Have faith that rejection might just mean redirection. A no isn't always a no. It's just a not right now.
Let's stop a panic attack right here. If you're at home, here's how to stop a panic attack. You keep lemons on hand. You keep lemons on hand. If you're having a panic attack, what you do is you grab one of the lemons and bite into it. This grounds you. Lemons are extremely bitter. When you bite into this, the texture, the bitterness, it's gonna stop the bullshit that's going on in here and focus you to force on your mouth. It will bring you out of a panic attack. That's why it's called grounding techniques. You know what? They work. It's using your senses and your strongest senses to bring you out of a panic attack. Panic attack is a massive amount of emotions, and it's so overwhelming that it feels like you're dying sometimes. It feels like you're having a heart attack. Lemons, the bitterness from these things, bite into them, get the juices into your mouth, get out of here and get back to here and fight through it. You're stronger than what battles that you're going through. You're an amazing human being. So find what works for you. We got this. You matter.
I live the worst that I've said, and I live with a voice that tends to tell me that I'm shit in my head. And well, maybe I should fuck it and be happy instead. I should just say fuck it and be happy instead.
In 5 days, it'll be 10 months since Courtney left us. 10 months since I've been a whole person. 10 months. And I still find it hard to breathe.
Bottles popping, bottles